Good morning. My name is Mahdi Veillet-Chowdhury. I'm an advanced imaging cardiologist here at WellSpan Hospital. And today I'm going to talk to you about an exciting new novel technology that we've been lucky to be a part of. And we'll share with you today our experiences on the new hybrid 4D cardiac CT lab in the Cath lab. So when we think of the Cath lab, it is used primarily for coronary interventions, for structural heart cases, for peripheral interventions, and EP procedures. We often will use ultrasound guidance with TTE, TEE, or ICE, combine that with fluoroscopy to really guide our procedures. Question is there a role for CT in this workflow? Is there a role for intraprocedural CT to help guide the procedures that are listed? Can we combine that with echo and the fluoro? What you can see here is there a role in intraprocedural CT for coronary interventions, meaning for stent placement or wire placement? Is there a role in structural heart cases? Example on the top right, is there a role for intraprocedural CT in delivery of this Watchman catheter while it remains attached to the delivery sheath before we release it? Is there a role in peripheral interventions and EP procedures? One of the EP procedures we don't typically think of in cath lab is cardioversions. So can we make use of the CT scanner in the cath lab to guide cardioversions? Here's our CT scanner. It is a Aquilian one. It's a volume scanner, so allows a 16 centimeter axial coverage. So it takes the images of the heart in one heartbeat. It has 275 millisecond rotation time and has low radiation. The C-arm is the Alphanex Sky Plus. It has remarkable flexibility, allows head-to-toe and fingertip-to-fingertip coverage. It allows for multimodality fusion and 3D road mapping. When we combine it, this is what it looks like. When we're using the C-arm, you can see that the CT scanner gantry is parked at the end of the sliding rail. And when we're ready to use the CT scanner, we'll just swing the C-arm out of the way while the patient remains still, catheters in place, sheath in place. We'll slide the CT scanner right over the patient, take our images, and then we'll slide the CT scanner back, swing the C-arm back into place, and move on with the procedure. Here's a picture of our suite. You can see that with the C-arm had remarkable flexibility. This really allows us to really make efficient use of our space with anesthesia, with ultrasound, with all the different personnel that's involved. It really does take a village for us to really get this journey going and having the success we've had. It is a multidisciplinary effort with interventional cardiology, EP, CT surgery, with all the different imaging cardiologists, sonographers, with our cath lab staff, radiologists, with the radiology CT staff, anesthesiologists. What we've had to do is really combine each of our procedural workflows, make best use of the space and time to really have an efficient procedure and in a safe manner, to have good outcomes. So this is it's been exciting. It's really opened our eyes with each of our specific disciplines and how we can really advance this field forward. When we think of the advantages of having a CT scanner in the cath lab, there's a couple buckets you can look into. One being, can we do same setting standard of care diagnostic and interventional procedures? Example being, say a patient has severe aortic stenosis, it's going to need a right and left heart catheterization. We'll also need a CT scanner. What can we do? We can combine them in the same setting. We can take advantage of the large bore sheath that's in place for the interventionalist that's placed for their indicated procedure to allow us to do a CT scan as well with lower contrast dose. So allows us to have really high quality images for planning and will also reduce contrast and can get it done in a very efficient time. And the next bucket you think about is intraprocedural evaluation for precise and accurate intervention. So example being same setting TAVR, same setting Watchman devices, same setting stent placements. Is there a role for CT in those cases? Also, having a CT scanner in the cath lab, there's often complications that are associated with these complex cases. So if there's ever a concern about perforation, fusion, retroperitoneal hemorrhage, having the CT scanner right there in place, we can quickly rule in or rule out those complications to take care of the patient in a very efficient manner. With the COVID-19 pandemic has emerged over the past year plus, this cardiac CT in itself has really progressed the field forward and allowing us to take care of our complex cardiac patients. One of the roles being assessment of left atrial appendage. There's been a lot of data that shows a very high sensitivity and accuracy of ruling in and ruling out appendage clot. So our patients, if they need a cardioversion, inpatient or outpatient, what we do is we bring them into our suite, we'll get a cardiac CT with low contrast dose, low radiation, get a quick delay if needed to rule in clot if there's slow flow. Once we've ruled it out, then we'll get anesthesia, we'll sedate them, and we'll cardiovert them. This is done very efficiently, no need for patient transfers, no TEE required or procedures requiring high risk of aerosolization. This has been practice changing. It really increased our throughput, made efficient use of beds, and it's going to be really hard to see how we're going to go back to TEE guided cardioversions post-COVID. This is a game changer in terms of appendage evaluation. Another utility and really amazing capability of this lab is the CT and fluoroscopy fusion. So it's an overlay of a 3D CT on a 2D fluoroscopy. This can allow for precise intervention, which can potentially lower the amount of contrast needed during those interventions. However, there are some disadvantages. It does have a steep learning curve and a static fusion, which means that it's not respiratory or ECG gated. But it is the building block to have true fusion moving forward between 3D CT and fluoroscopy. To close, I'm going to discuss a case where we were able to utilize the lab to its fullest. This is a case of a 78-year-old woman. She's got a CHADS VASC of 3 and a HAS bled of 2, needing an appendage occlusion. As you can see, this is a really small left atrial appendage, really vestigial organ that didn't really meet requirements for a standard left atrial occlusion device. We needed to get a 3D print, actually, that demonstrated we needed an ASO occluder device. So after that, we brought the patient into our lab. Using the CT overlay, we're able to demonstrate the occluded device within the neck of the ostium. When we are satisfied with that, we did a CT scan with the device attached to the delivery sheath, demonstrated complete occlusion of the appendage, knowing that we had 100% success of this, and we were able to reduce this patient's risk of bleeding and stroke. So to close, my colleagues in the upcoming talks will give a little bit more details on their specific disciplines. This hybrid 4D CT cath lab can really allow us to have precise and accurate pre-planning and intra-procedural guidance. Question is, does this improve outcomes? And that's something we're going to answer over the next few years. This also has a really good opportunity to have efficient utilization of resources. How I mentioned, it's changed our workflow and pathway for cardioversions, as well as same setting, heart catheterizations, and CT pre-planning for TAVRs. This has increased patient throughput, increased patient satisfaction, and has allowed us to do it in a safe manner, potentially using lower contrast. Also, another question moving forward is, this hybrid lab really has a niche to look for cost-effective analysis for these different indications. So moving in healthcare, we're always trying to figure out, is there a way we can reduce costs? And being able to combine CT and fluoro in the same setting, it really has the opportunity and potential to reduce costs in this complex health environment.
So on that note, I want to thank you for your time.